have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Redskins going up against the Rams.
We have played 266 games in this NFL season. Only one remains, and it's the biggest of them all, as EA Sports is proud to present coverage of the Super Bowl. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. Field it about a yard deep. Oh, another great move. And he'll weave his way up, all the way up, a few yards shy of midfield. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. Last year's number one overall pick, here he comes. He'll be leading them and looking for an improvement in year two, Jared Goff.
Didn't play in a traditional pro-style offense in college. In fact, the Cali Bear, they call the Bear Raid, thrown around a whole bunch. 96 touchdown passes in three seasons. This guy took the ball from game one as a true freshman and never missed a start. He has a great amount of toughness as well as the ability to throw the big time ball downfield.
16 yards on the game's first play and a quick first down. Now gone.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw into the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that they'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he gets receiver hit and hit hard.
On first down, gone. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They establish the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
They go play action with Gurley. Now gone. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. It'll be a pickup of only a yard. And that'll bring up a third down. And here's the Redskin defense.
When we made the decision to magnify Trent Murphy, the reason I wanted to talk about him was this is a guy who has learned how to play the position, has grown into understanding what his body does best. Long-arm guy, gets his hands on an offensive player, and when he locks out and goes and makes a play, that's what puts him at his best.
He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's fourth.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
So the opening drive for him here on their home turf results in a field goal.
And that's the way you want to get things started. Your stadium, your crowd, you got the ball, put points on the board first, and let everyone start to celebrate.
This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So out comes the Redskins offense now onto the field. They'll be led out by Kirk Cousins, their Pro Bowl quarterback, in his sixth season now.
I think he just gets better and better. He was third in the NFL in passing yardage in 2016. In fact, over the last two seasons, over 9,000 yards passing, the fourth most in the NFL.
And he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, add that play to his resume, real, because he went to the Pro Bowl last year. That's how you go to the Pro Bowl. You make plays like that, big-time penetration, and throw people for losses.
So one quarter down here in the Super Bowl. 3-0 is our score. You're watching the NFL on E! Back live, Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Gordon. It's Redskin football to begin quarter number two. But they face a second and long to start things out. They'll keep it in the hands of Kelly. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. It gets them a little over half of what they need, and now they're looking at a third and five.
They got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
Cousins from the gun, one third. And here comes a Cousins lost the football. Titans have got it. Going the other way.
Defense has been good, and they were good again there.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for six. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And I will say this, I'm thankful because it's comfortably right around 70 degrees in here right now. But when we walked in the stadium today, it's 14 degrees outside. We're just glad this one's indoors.
You're not the only one thankful. Think about all the out-of-town visitors who came in for this game. They're very thankful to have an indoor stadium. But you remember, for that time frame, in between when they were building the new stadium and the Vikings were playing their home games outdoors, you get into late November, December, early January, it felt a lot like what it felt like outside today. I'm very happy to make that a dome.
Yeah, we can't have a Super Bowl in 14-degree weather. Long swing towards, and that's where we're at. They were trying to get it there to Josh Doctson, and it's third and four.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they're searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
Now Cousins. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Mark Barron. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line.
But this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you get a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
On first down, it's Gurley. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Now that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't they? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Now gone. Carson's got it left side. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone and the chalk of the 20. A very solid gain of 27.
When I watched Jared Goff on tape at Cal, I saw a guy who wasn't just a dart thrower. You know, a lot of people said, oh, he's perfect for the West Coast offense. I always thought he could do a little bit more, and that was the reason why. He could push it downfield. He has a good strong arm.
That nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let him get away. But it does get away, and it's second down.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. They had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys did not play offense.
All the move to its left. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
But there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Throwing on third. Gone.
Especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that can finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Zuerlein now for the PAT. got it, and it's 17-0. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And the result for the Rams, a touchdown. Zerline out now to kick this one away. Now it's Chris Thompson on the return. And out of that return, here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Redskins offense now, they get set to take over here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory, just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down, they're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
Now Cousins. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Jamison Crowder there. And it'll bring up third down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Fly into the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another hot job there, folks, in the completion.
Throwing. Cousins. And this is Brian by fire. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Now Washington going to use the second of their 3 timeouts as the final stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Here's Cousin. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Alec Ogletree coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7. Second down, Cousin. And he's going to go down again. And this pass rush drawing now. That sacks on back-to-back plays. So as the set designers rush out here to get us ready for the spectacle to come at intermission.
You seriously just skip the halftime of the Super Bowl? Who does that?
It's a Super Bowl. Watch the halftime show.
Yeah, here we go. Third quarter action now. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This one taken just inside the 10. And out of that return, here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. They come out here with a 0 on the scoreboard. What was set in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I'd love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or do they think just they were just bad plays to call? Yeah. They got that pretty quickly here. If they felt they had something going, they just needed to do it a little bit better than that.
We'll find out. It's a game of 4 there that gives them a new set of downs.
Well, that'll be the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
They'll go again with Kelly. And the ball closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
That was second down throw for Cousins. This one complete to Jordan Reed. And he'll get up near the 45 of spot at the 44. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had to read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game. Sometimes with a running game, you just got to stick with it. Look, this is the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays. But stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And he's going to lose yardage yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. One quarter remains here in the back now here on EA Sports. It's the Redskins with the football, but trailing here as we get down to the good stuff. Quarter number four. Cousins now on second down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. Moving back at the 36. Time for a break. We're back to crown a champion after this. So it's Redskin football here as we welcome you back. If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Pressure too much that time as Cousins goes down. Ethan Westbrook's in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't matter. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over.
To his right. And it's a fumble. And the Redskins scoop it. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line.
It's an excellent call. Most teams don't have as many goals for the game like we used to have when you checked off your boxes. But 0 turnovers, that's a universal. And while what likely cost them in this game, they're going to regret the fact that they caught one up here.
Yeah, their first blemish. They had mistake-free football prior. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On first and 10, Goff. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has absorbed the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
On second and 10, Goff. It's still caught at about the 5. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Goff to Austin that time for an L.A. first down.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but at this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
Out of the gun, Goff. Able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
Yeah. He will score. Touchdown, Jared Goff, his second touchdown in the Super Bowl. And the Rams use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. So a quarterback scramble, certainly a pass play, but he saw something, tucked it, and got in the end zone.
A lot of quarterbacks, when they scramble, they're scrambling to create more time to throw the ball downfield. In this situation, as you noted, he tucked it and took off. Great play by him.
Now Zerline on and the extra point. And the lead is now 24. Zerline out now to kick this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. Now a hit and a loose football. And now the Rams have got it going the other way. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.
As that ball got away from him and he saw the opposing team recover it.
He felt his pain.
Oh, I felt his pain and you know what was going through his head. Tucking away. Taking care of the ball. All the things he heard all week in practice. He didn't carry it over into the game.
That good for 19 and a first down.
This stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage just come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up enough.
and goal. Gurley.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Again, yet another touchdown that sent his hand to their totals.
And to me, that's a shout loud you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Zerline now for the PAT. And they're able to up the lead by one more. Well, that drive started with not a whole lot of real estate in front of them. In plus territory, excellent field position. Two plays later, pay dirt. Zerline out now to kick this one away. Let's feel it at the two. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. They are down big. They have not scored a single point. I don't know. Are they so defeated at this point you just want to get in the locker room and get the heck out of here?
That is one way to approach it. Sometimes, folks, that's it.
Okay. Under pressure, they got him again. The Redskins now going to use the first of their three timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game. They're working out of the gun. Cousins. George Dotson's got it complete. And all the way down to the 26. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as they stop it with 14 seconds to go in the game. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Cousins now throwing first down. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. Jordan Reed was the intended target. That'll bring up second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a second goal. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Looking for his running back, and he's got it. And they just took a timeout with 2 seconds to go. This one obviously decided. Not sure they needed to take it, but we'll take it with them. And welcome back, the offensive unit. They took the timeout, and now they get set to line up as we resume action. One last shot now for Cousins. Cousins lost the football. The Rams have won the Super Bowl, and they will get the Lombardi Trophy. And when this moment comes, I think you look back at all the blood, sweat, and tears, the offseason, the workouts, training camp, week one, two, three, all building up now to say you're a Super Bowl champion. It's worth it.
It certainly is, and rarely do we have a team that holds the Lombardi Trophy that didn't have their share of bumps along the way, didn't have to face some adversity in the journey, and now they get to just enjoy it and revel in it. And all offseason, they'll be signing their autographs with Super Bowl champion underneath it.
They end this year just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.